is a quick start video tutorial for the Teosui Sketches app. We are going to be looking at the pro version of the app. The free version has less features and less customization, but is actually a very good app as well. This is the latest version of the app, which came out in the spring of 2016, which added a lot of features. So when you begin, you will have these little books that you can put together with your sketches to organize them. Tap one and tap here on the plus to add a new sketch. Your tools will run along the left side here, and they are quite easy and intuitive to use. Let's start here. We have a pencil. We have a thin line marker. We have a thicker line marker. And I want to point out that if you tap and hold on any of the tools, you will have the ability to change both the width of the line and the opacity. So you do have some ability to customize each of these tools. You also will see that there are some other options for each tool as well. That's kind of a inking brush. We've got a crayon that's nice and bumpy, a paint tool. We have the watercolor, which is very, very nice. And we have a spray. This pen is kind of cool because it has kind of a real wavy, inky line. This tool allows you to come up with patterns. It has three sets of patterns for you to look at. And when you pick a pattern, and if you draw, it will fill the shape with that pattern, which is very helpful. It also, if you tap and hold, it will fill in the background with the pattern or a solid color if you wish. The undo is up in this corner, this little arrow here. We'll do your undo for you. This tool also has available for you a few fonts that you can use for text, and also some shapes that you can use, which sometimes can be kind of nice and helpful for something special. And when the shape comes in, you can customize it, move it, and then either hit the X to get rid of it or the check to make it stay. Your eraser tool is right here, obviously. This is a blending tool. And when you first use some of these tools, there will be a little menu that will pop up that will give you some instruction. So this kind of smudges or blends. And this tool is new in this version that just came out, which is the tool that I love the most, is this knife, because I can select part of my drawing and then I can move it where I want, and I can also resize. It also sometimes does this weird duplicate, which I haven't quite figured out how to stop that from happening. Obviously, there's some gesture that I'm doing that's causing that to happen, so you got to be a little careful with that sometimes. Will happen. And then finally, we have this tool here, which is a straight line tool that will allow you to draw with a ruler, and your lines will be perfectly straight. Down in this corner here is where your colors are. They have some set colors. You can also add your own color and pick out different shades and hues and customize it any way you like. Oops, let's take off that little. And then here's another color. And one other tool that's helpful, trick is helpful to know, is if you press and hold, it will bring up a little eyedropper, which allows you to match tools. So sometimes I'll just make little spots on my screen with the colors that I want to use so that I can match them. Over here is where your layers are located. And you have three layers that you can use. The layers can be moved around. They can also be merged one on top of each another, just by simply grabbing them and dropping them, and it'll give you that option to merge. The very bottom layer, if you hit this little gear, will give you some options for background color, but also it will give you options for lines and a grid. I love to draw with a grid. And what's great about the grid is, if you're zooming in to write something, it helps you to know the sizing and also helps you with keeping things lined up. And you can always turn the grid off when you are done with your drawing if you want. If you tap these three little dots at the top, you've got some options here. This is where your tools are. And there's some things that you can set up, including having the undo redo button and that eyedropper. You do have to turn that on. So if it's not working, check for that. You also have from right here the option to bring in a photo, either from your camera roll or your camera. So, and you can move that around and resize it before you drop it. And then the box with the arrow going out gives you all the options for saving, including to your photo album. And I do want to show you something about how it exports to the photo album. Let me go here and show you where what happens is it exports it, the whole picture, but it also exports the three layers. And what's great about that is the layers preserve transparency. So if you want to put this in as a transparent image in a presentation or merge it with something else, that transparency is really nice that it automatically saves that for you. And then the final feature that they've recently added is this video feature, where you can actually create a video in real time of your drawing process. And so that is also really nifty as well. When you are done, you just simply pinch and it will save it to your album and you will be all set. So that is a quick overview of the Teisui Sketches app.